Some topics of the day. Now, while healthcare and living costs are the biggest issues worrying voters in the upcoming election, concern from the environment has increased more than ever before.
That is according to the Ipsos Issues Monitor, which revealed that it's not just younger voters who are feeling a little bit uneasy with the state of the environment. It is time now to go head-to-head with Nine Honey's Shelley Horton and WSFM's Brendan Jones.
Hello.
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 To you,
Happy Sunday.
Happy Easter.
Easter Sunday.
Yeah, you guys
exactly.
Are covered.
Now, yeah. Shelley, is the environment at the top of your concerns?
No, it's not for me, but also I think that that shows the age group that I'm in. So I'm looking more at owning property, concerned about my business and tax, but I love that we've got the under 25s who are concerned about the environment. I think that, you know, we need to have each generation represented in the election, and this is how they're going to have a say. And I think for one of the first times in a long time, they realise if you care about the environment, you can make a difference through voting, and I think that's a great thing.
You know, Jonesy, we were talking before about these arrests that happened in London for this environmental protest. Mm-hmm. Emma Thompson was one of those people who was at this protest. So there is a new generational shift of people who are realising that we're at a crisis point. Do you feel like this is a step in the right direction?
Well, us young people, unlike Shelley, I'm concerned about the future because, if to quote Mike and McCann, every generation blames the one before.
Yeah.
So, you know, if we don't leave anything for our kids, what's going to happen to me?
Yeah.
Me being the kids, the future.
Well, they're going to look after you, and they're going to be pretty awful about it if you've...
My kids aren't going to look after me. My kids are going to be terrible.
Yeah, right.
But I think it's good. You know, climate change has been happening since day one, since the world started cooling. It's always going to happen, and it's good to see that the kids are on the case.
Do you think the politicians are listening to them?
I think they have to. I think that a lot of them are sort of... Because the problem is we have a lot of stuff in our country that goes against our natural resources. Unfortunately, happen to be a lot of coal. Mm. And that... Our country really relies on that, so you can't just suddenly say, well, let's just shut down the coal mine and see how we go with a wind farm.
But you can admit that climate change is an issue and it's changing,
definitely.
And that's the problem. There's a lot of our politicians are
deniers. But I don't know why they drag their feet on that. I don't know why they, you know...
Maybe it's the people who pay for their campaigns.
Oh, you're saying that there's
what?
Labor
what?
Controversial. Dare you on an Easter Sunday too.
Yeah. Well, speaking of Easter Sunday, we're all probably eating a lot of chocolate today, mm-hmm. but junk food ads are going to be banned from publicly owned sites under a crackdown on childhood obesity by the Queensland government.
Yeah, that's because high-fat, high-salt, sugar products would no longer be allowed to advertise on bus shelters, the rail network, outside major hospitals. Shelley, you're nodding in this.
Yeah.
I think sports grounds will still be able to advertise this sort of stuff, but... This is happening in Brisbane and Queensland. Should we do this right across Australia?
I love this so much. This is actually a great example of the government using the power that they do have, which is they're in charge of those shelters and the things that they have put in place. So this is great because you know what? Every little bit counts. And I think it's not so much that it's a, you know, convincing kids to eat junk food. It's that pester factor for the parents of they see an ad for KFC and then it's like, we want KFC, we want KFC.
Oh,
so
yeah.
I think that that's going to help as well. But also I just think let's do as much as we can because obesity is such an issue in this country. Every little bit counts.
Are you on board, Jonesy?
I could go some KFC right now.
Yeah, that's just the same, right?
Can I get a three-piece feed here? You know, when I was a kid, they used to have cigarette advertising. Remember?
Yeah.
I don't know if you guys remember that, but it was such
Joe
a...
Joe Camel, man.
And we'd sit there and I remember, because I used to smoke as a young... Well, when I was about 12, because that's what you did in the 70s. Well, that's what they did. Everyone smoked back then.
You can't wear seatbelts.
Hide from the past. But the thing about it, I remember being a youngster saying, well, advertising never influenced me in smoking as I'm smoking away at, you know...
Yeah.
And I smoked up until I was about 40. The advertising, I think in the years to come, we're going to see confectionery or junk food advertising will be what cigarette advertising was to the 70s. So it's, you know, it's going to happen.
Controversial.
I don't know if it's controversial.
I think it is. I think you put it out there. You're saying you want to ban all advertising.
Ban all advertising. Ironically,
that's
what you've said.
Set for advertising here.
Come at him, sleeping giants. hey, Brisbane cosmetic surgeons, stay up in Brisbane, have reported a 20 to 30% increase in male clients claiming it's because of our image-obsessed society.
Yeah, they say most men are requesting to look like George Clooney. And popular treatments include calf implants,
poor calves,
injectables, and chin enhancement surgery. You don't need surgery, Jonesy, do you?
No, I don't need.
Come on. Does your
chin
this
rack didn't work on itself. you know, I don't get calf surgery. What guys
have? Yeah. No, that's
is that a thing now?
Yes, yeah, because at the gym, a lot of guys just genetically don't have big calf muscles, and calf
chicken
muscles
legs
are very, very, very hard to develop.
Are they attractive?
Yeah. Yes.
Do girls dig calves?
Oh, is it?
Hey, my eyes are up here. My calves are down here.
Do you think that these men are getting calf implants for girls? No, they're doing it to make themselves feel good because they are looking in the mirror a lot
more than they used to. We're also obsessed with how we look these days.
I am pro surgery. I am pro injectables. Do whatever you want because I actually think it comes down to self-esteem.
Yeah. Whatever blows your fake hair back.
Okay.
I'd look cross, but I haven't got too much Botox.
We can't let you go. We've got to talk about this one other story that's caught our eye this morning. This Thursday, of course, is Anzac Day. And to mark the occasion, a new kind of Anzac biscuit has just been released.
Oh, yum.
It's called the half biscuit because it's made with a mix of Australian and New Zealand ingredients. I had one of these yesterday. They're pretty good. Shelley, two countries coming together. One delicious treat. Is there anything else from New Zealand that we should be pinching?
I think this would go with a nice New Zealand Pinot.
Oh, that's good, yeah.
Very nice.
So hang on, so it's a half, so you join it with another half.
Oh, it
like
looks
those
like
necklaces.
A half.
So, like, so yes. My best friend necklaces. So
I've got a Kiwi cousin called Brendan.
Oh, together.
And I've got my jindals and we're all together.
No, oh, you're got, kind of Josh, actually looks a bit rude.
I'm surprised nobody said, can we have Jacinda Ardern? But anyway, if we have these, is that a guarantee?
But we got Anzac biscuits. You're not allowed to call them cookies. That's a
no
thing.
No, you're
not. Oh, because that's American.
Yeah. All right. Thanks, guys.
Thanks, team. That's
still
it.
To come.
Sorry to disappoint you, Jonesy. You can employ.